it's just one of those like once in a lifetime opportunities that you never get.
It only took them about two words to convince me that, okay, I really wanted to do this.
Because of this trip, in the future I probably would end up doing something really similarly humanitarian.
How many times can as students have the opportunity to go to a part of the world where you can on a daily basis interact with people that live with less than $500 a year? This is why the partnership between the College of Engineering and Applied Sciences and the Turkana Basin Institute is providing a unique opportunity for us to start programs that directly engage students and enable them to have a unique cultural experience.
We go there to work specifically with the community, try to make their life a little easier, and try to understand how different life is in other places in the world.
This was so unique, where you go to an area which it's completely undeveloped. They struggle even for water, for food.
When we go to the field, we identify problems that they're going to be working on for their next 5 weeks.
In Kenya, there's too much fluoride in the water. And when there's too much fluoride in the water, it can cause bone deformities, it can cause severe dental fluorosis. So my idea was to use bones to take the fluoride out.
This is too thin, right?
Yeah, it's a little too thin.
Bone charcoal has a very good way of removing fluoride from the water, and there's a lot of bones in Kenya. The people there are hunter-gatherers, so they herd a lot of sheep and goats, and since they have a lot of sheep and goats, there's a lot of bones. We actually created some bone charcoal there ourselves, and then we tested it, and our tests provided significant results for us, and we were really excited. Me and my partner were just kind of like, oh my gosh, we got results, they work! Bone charcoal works. And so we presented them to the local people, we presented it to a local representative. The fact that this is such a viable solution for them made them very, very excited for possible outcomes.
Having the experience of interacting with the community like the way we do, and having the opportunity to do engineering or do innovation the way we do, is very unique.
So the maternity ward at a local health clinic had no drainage. Just had a bunch of sinks that went straight to the floor and then went out of the building and puddled in the back, and it would puddle where people might play in it or whatever. So me and my friend Joe, with the help of our professor Rodrigo, came with a system using old barrels, pipes, and tubing to get it out of the building underground and have it percolate into the soil.
They were working super motivated because of what they saw.
So can you get in there and stop a little bit?
And compact it?
Yeah.
Working on my project was great because we had locals from around the village would just come and pick up a shovel and dig with us. And I brought some music and a speaker so they would dance. Help us dig, and it was just awesome having them help, even though there's a bit of a language barrier there.
They get to understand what it is to develop off-grid engineering solutions.
The main problem at the Ilere community that I was focusing on was the fact that the solar panels that they had at the local school and the local clinic were non-functioning. They had no energy, so they had no lights. If a woman wanted to give labor at night, the staff had to use flashlights in their mouth to help deliver the baby. That was pretty difficult. So pretty much everything that was after sunlight, it became a problem for the community, and this was going on for a long time. So what we decided to do was to mend this equipment. I was climbing roofs and at one point fixing one of the solar panels with another friend from Kenya.
Giancarlos, what are you doing?
I am disassembling one of the charge controller units to replace it in the clinic. And we did it. In the end, the local staff and the local students, they were very happy about the outcome. They now have energy they now have lights for any time at night, and the local school now has power outlets, so they can charge about any electronics and they can use any computer.
If you're just like nervous that you're not an engineering major, there's still a purpose for you there. You're still very, very needed. I saw a lot of like water bottles that were just scattered around everywhere. So I decided to make those into instruments. All I did was kind of make like a basic drum, like hit it against my wrist or anything else, or like put rocks in it and like shake it around. And then I took what I made and I went to this school, and we gathered a bunch of the school kids and even a couple of the kids from the community, and I actually ran a music club. They all really loved it. They all were really great at rhythms, and they really picked up instruments very quickly. And even though we didn't speak the same language, if I played something, they were able to improvise off of it.
We were very welcomed by the community. We were very receptive to them, and they were extremely receptive to us.
We played soccer, a lot of soccer.
Every 2 days, we were playing soccer with everybody.
And it became like a bonding experience.
And I think we beat the local Kenyans in at least one game, but then lost most of the rest, so that was really fun.
The other thing that I myself did for fun was actually dancing with the kids. And I was singing the song like Bailando Cuerpo Alegría Macarena, and the kids just started like laughing, and they started like imitating it. And then for the entire trip, everybody knew me as Macarena.
It was really nice to just like get to know the people there, like personally.
Being able to interact with them and see how happy they were despite not having, you know, the internet, not having your cell phone to play around with. It was just really fulfilling because they were just so happy without all these things.
It could be so much that we have in different, but in the end, we're all the same. We like to have fun, we like to share sentiments, we like to share feelings.
I knew from a while ago that I always wanted to do something that would make a change in the world, and I just never knew how to do it, and once I went onto this trip, I found that, oh, making a change is a lot easier than you think.
Going on this program has really made me realize what I actually want to be, and it really like solidified my dreams.
This is actually something that I really want to dedicate my life to.
As cliche as it sounds, it's a lifetime experience.